Coming up, we'll see Carl Lewis as he anchors the men's 4x100 relay team.
And now that speedy quartet will, figuratively at least, pass the baton to their male counterparts, because just ahead, it's the men's 4x100 meter relay. The United States, as always, has four of the world's fastest men, but even so, if past history is any indication, this is anything but a gimme gold, because speed alone doesn't always win a relay race. It happens so fast, we sometimes don't see it. Look again. It's 11 and a half inches of hollow aluminum tubing weighing less than 2 ounces. But the seemingly simple task of passing the baton from one runner to the next during the 4x100 meter relay always produces the most harrowing moments for the United States track team.
In a relay, you have to be perfect or very close to perfect every time you come out, because it's not easy to hit a moving target.
We obviously have the most speed. We've always had the most speed in the world, but I don't think that we've had this consistent concept of how to pass the baton, and that's what's been the most difficult part.
Carl Lewis is right. Adding individual 100-meter times, the United States is indeed the fastest team in tonight's field. But what makes the relay interesting is the unpredictability of the baton pass. Traveling at more than 20 miles per hour, runners enter the 20-meter passing zone and must match their speed with the outgoing runners. To maintain speed, the departing runner does not look back, and the incoming runner does not slow down. This handoff occurs 3 times, but without timing, instinct, and steel nerves, the pass doesn't happen.
The way I always teach it in my classes, if they come in at full speed, you go out full speed. They come in slow, you go out slow. If they come in on their hands and knees, you go out on your hands and knees. The timing is where they both are going at the same speed.
13 times in 16 Olympics, the U.S. has completed its passes and won the gold, its last coming in 1984. But there have been miscues which turned into disasters. The first came in 1912 in the first Olympic sprint relay. The Americans were disqualified in the semifinal for passing outside the zone. It happened again in 1960 in Rome. The race was billed as a showdown between the favored U.S. and the West Germans. The Americans crossed the finish line first, but judges ruled the first baton exchange was out of the legal passing zone, and they were disqualified. The USA's passing woes struck again in 1988. In the first round, the USA's Lee McNeil couldn't grab the wavering baton from Calvin Smith until both were several meters beyond the legal handoff zone. Then, at the 1991 World Championships, it was the U.S. women's turn.
Oh, and the U.S. has dropped the baton. The U.S. drops the baton.
At Barcelona, the U.S. team has something that may guarantee success, and that's continuity. Following 6 weeks of discussion and an injury to Mark Witherspoon, the U.S. coaches have selected 3 of the 4 athletes who broke the world record last year in Tokyo. Carl Lewis, Leroy Burrell, and Dennis Mitchell. Running leadoff is Olympic 200-meter champ Mike Marsh. With all the experience, these four are not likely to be haunted by past failures.
If I thought about that, you know, it wouldn't be productive. You know, it's not positive thinking. And, you know, what we have to do is just go out there and do our job. We can't let nerves or the past or anything else get to us.
True enough, but a little luck wouldn't hurt.
The U.S. holds the world record. They set it at the World Championships last year, and 3 of the 4 members of this team were on that world record-setting team. Leadoff leg for the U.S. will be Mike Marsh, former parking attendant at the Los Angeles Olympics, now the gold medal winner in the 200-meter dash. In the second leg, Leroy Burrell, former world record holder in the 100-meter dash. The third leg, Dennis Mitchell, bronze medal winner in the 100 here in Barcelona. And the anchor, Carl Lewis. King Carl, who looked to be his old self yesterday as he ran the anchor leg, he has anchored 5 world record-setting 4x100 teams.
Now, this took place moments ago. You see Carl Lewis, he's marking off what we call his goal mark. He marked off 31 feet. He puts a piece of tape down. And when Dennis Mitchell hits that tape, that's when Carl is going to take off. All week long, they've been doing it at about 26 feet because they wanted safe passes. Today, they're going to 31 feet.
This will be our last chance to see Carl Lewis in the Olympic Games. The United States, the heavy favorite in lane 4. This team for the United States includes the 3 fastest men in history. Lewis, the world record holder, Burrell, and Mitchell, plus Marsh. He's the slow man on this four-man team, and all he did was win the gold in the 200.
If this team was one team, if they hung out together and worked out together as a relay team, they could take a full second off the world record. The problem is, to work on baton passes, you got to run all out. And most of these guys are concentrating on their individual events, so they don't have the time to train and run all out, because you never know what strength the guy is going to have when he comes into that passing zone. Some guys will be dying. Some guys like Carl Lewis or Burrell or a good 200 man can be stronger at the end of 100 meters.
Mike Marsh runs the leadoff leg, and the first time the U.S. took the track yesterday morning in the qualifying heat, he was pretty shaky in his leadoff and in his baton pass to Leroy Burrell.
Well, the night before he had won the 200 meters, you can imagine he didn't get to sleep too early that night, and he was just a little tight. But he looked a lot better yesterday afternoon.
The United States was disqualified for passing out of the zone at the 1988 Olympics in Seoul when they were similarly favored.
That's where you run the risk when you go back to 31 or 32 feet as a goal marker.
On the leadoff leg for the United States in lane four, and Marsh is away well. Here's the pass to Leroy Burrell. A good pass to Burrell, and Burrell sets sail down the backstretch. The Nigerians and the British are running well too. Now Burrell passes to Dennis Mitchell. Mitchell on the third leg runs the curve, and Mitchell takes off for the U.S. Now here comes the anchor. Carl Lewis awaits the baton. Here's the pass from Mitchell to Lewis, and Lewis sets off down the stretch with the lead. In his final Olympic Games, blazing to the finish for the U.S. What about the world record? Yes! Yes!
That was the goal. A world record. Once again, I believe this world record was broken on sheer foot speed and average passes. This is a good pass, though. Burrell is well in the passing zone. Good extension with his hand. Didn't have to slow down too much. Let's take a look at the pass from Leroy to Dennis Mitchell. Dennis may have gotten a little too much of the baton. Let's take a look at Carl Lewis. For the first time, he started on the outside of the lane. Normally, he starts on the inside of the lane. It throws him off balance sometimes, but Carl Lewis, one of the few anchor men, will take the baton in one hand and switch hands. This may be the biggest difference in the preliminary races in this race, the leg that Mike Marsh ran. As I said, he didn't run particularly well in the previous races, but in this race, he ran real well. And that was, once again, not a great pass, but not a bad pass. As Dennis Mitchell gets the baton, in the middle of the baton, but as he's run, somehow he manages to shimmy that hand down to the bottom of the baton, so there's some room to pass off to Carl Lewis, who, unlike anyone else, changed hands with that baton. And we're going to find out later on this year who really is the world's fastest human when Carl challenges Linford Christie, the gold medal winner.
Did that replay seem fast? It was in real time. Let's slow it down and get a better look at Carl Lewis.
Carl Lewis, who said he had a virus in the Olympic trials, But the way he ran these two anchor legs yesterday and today, I would say right now, my money would be on him in a match race with the gold medal winner, Linford Christie.
Look at Carl reacting as he looked at the clock and saw the world record, and Burrell waiting for the time. Yes! That was exciting.
The world record was only the only true challenge for these guys. There's no way they should lose to these other guys here based on sheer foot speed. But they were challenged by the world record. They took some gambles, and they got the world record.
Well, the American flag, an appropriate background for that performance that set 70,000 people on edge here. The U.S. world record, 37.40. Nigeria, the silver, and Cuba, the bronze. Todd Christensen has the winners.
All right, thanks a lot, Tom. You know what? The wind was swirling. I thought there was absolutely no way that there was going to be a world record. But, Mike, you got the U.S. team off to a great start.
Well, all I needed was a good night's sleep, you know, and a little motivation, a little pressure. You know, the handoffs were good. We felt great. We got the world record in this win, and we can go faster.
You know what, Leroy? I'm thinking to myself that the world record in the 4x1 must be old hat to you, but certainly a gold medal, isn't it?
Well, you know, I've been on a lot of them. We've broken it or tied it quite a few times, Santa Monica and USA. And, you know, I'm a man who's had a lot of world records, but, you know, this Olympic gold means much more than all eight of them or nine. I don't even know how many it is.
You know what? I'm here talking now with the ultimate warrior of track and field. You know what? I know that everybody wants to run the anchor, but Dennis, you own that curve.
Well, I made it a point to myself and to everybody else that are my fans and that enjoy people who run the inside legs. I just want to go out there and do the best that I can on that third leg and just burn that sucker up.
You know, I was thinking, Carl, everybody's right. It's obvious you've lost a whale of a lot. Two more gold medals now in anchoring another world record. It must feel fabulous.
I tell you, when you got a dream team in front of you, it makes life a lot easier. Those guys put on a clinic out here and just gave me a lead. All I had to do was run for a record. So I'm excited about that. These are the best three teammates I could have ever had. I mean, I'm happy to be on this team, but I also have to say that this race was for Mark because Mark got injured on this track and he wasn't able to run it today. And I was only running because he didn't, but homie, this is for you. And I also want to say happy birthday to Carol, birthday today.
That's great for you, Mark Witherspoon, but please, Tom and OJ, if I could have just had the speed of one of these guys when I was playing, just one.
Juice told me you had taken more than that, Todd, but... Teammates, training partners, best friends, Leroy Burrell and Carl Lewis celebrate another world record. And who says there's only one dream team in Barcelona, huh? For Carl Lewis, gold medal number 8.